This is the Saeta P494, an Italian gunboat, which is the final vessel in Tier 2, and is placed at a BR of 4.3. At the time of making this video, the Saeta is actually the only naval vessel in War Thunder to be equipped with guided weaponry in the form of its Sea Killer Mark 1 missiles. These have a range of 10 kilometers or 6.2 miles and a maximum velocity of 280 meters per second. The warhead that is carried by these missiles has just over 25 kilograms of TNT equivalent explosive and also features a proximity fuse, making these ideal for engaging enemy air targets. The missiles are carried in a 5-round launcher just behind the Saeta's bridge and smoke funnel structure, which does mean that the launcher cannot be aimed towards the bow, but rather has a 260 degree turning arc, of which it navigates at a speed of 11 degrees per second. Despite being the Saeta's defining feature, the missile launcher is not actually the main weapon on this vessel. That role goes to a pair of 40mm Breda Bofors Type 107 cannons, one mounted at the bow and one mounted at the stern. These guns have access to two types of ammunition, firstly high explosive fragmentation incendiary tracer belts, or high explosive variable time fuse belts, the latter of which has a 7m trigger radius, making it quite useful for dealing with pesky enemy aircraft. Both of these turrets have a full 360 degree turning arc and can traverse at 95 degrees per second. This is certainly fast enough to keep up with most surface targets and most air targets that you will encounter. These guns do have a limited amount of armor, which will aid in keeping them operational against enemy fire, although this is the only armor on the entire vessel. In short, these 40mm are great for dealing with smaller boats and can be used to take down destroyers, although it will commonly take a while to knock down the enemy crew to a point that the ship will go down. When spaded, the Saeta can reach up to 74 kilometers per hour or 46 miles an hour, making it the fastest researchable vessel of Italian Tier 2. This will usually allow for you to reach a favorable position before you begin to encounter enemy units. While displacing 210 tons, which is more than its predecessor, the Fulgor, the Saeta actually has a lower crew count, with 36 sailors on board compared to the Fulgor's 38. That aside though, the Saeta will commonly survive a fair few hits when brawling with other gunboats, although will not stand much of a chance when facing the main guns of destroyers and some of the cruisers that it may find itself encountering. These will commonly be able to destroy the Saeta after only one or two direct hits, so sticking to the more covered areas of most maps is certainly an advisable move. The vessel actually uses a hybrid propulsion system comprising of two Fiat-built diesel engines driving the outer propellers and a Bristol-Siddeley Proteus turbojet driving the center propeller. The Proteus series actually does have a rather interesting history of being used for many other uses such as aircraft, hovercraft, and even the Bluebird CN7 land speed record car. In fact, another Proteus can be seen in the Italian naval line powering the Spaviero gunboat, which is also placed at Tier 2. A few more things to mention, the Saeta does have a radar system with both a searching radar and a tracking radar. This will allow for you to detect and lock onto enemy aircraft, giving you various statistics on their range and how quickly they are approaching or flying away from you. This radar system will also give you a lead indicator when locking onto a target, which will make it much easier to engage air targets with your 40mm cannons. Unfortunately, the Saeta does not have any available secondary camouflage options. The standard scheme is rather empty, though thankfully a historical user skin was recently added to Live.WarThunder, which looks much more aesthetically pleasing than the standard paint scheme. I do hope that this user skin will come to the Gaijin market, although that is probably wishful thinking. So moving over to some gameplay, we're going to be looking at a few matches from Naval RB to demonstrate the capabilities of the Saeta. So our first game is on Japanese port. Not exactly a huge amount of cover on this map for the smaller boats. There's a few larger sort of urban islands, so to speak, but there's not necessarily much cover. In this game, I'm more getting a lot closer to the enemy small boats than I would like to, and just spamming my missiles, just trying to get as many kills as quickly as possible. The second game, we play a bit more of a sort of covered, a bit more of a sneaky play style, trying not to be seen by the enemy. One missile did miss. First missile, of course, killed an enemy vessel. Second missile missed. Third missile took out an enemy vessel who had shot me, done a bit of damage, set me on fire. Luckily, though, at the time of making this video, I had spaded the vessel, so I was able to put that fire out. Three kills, though, very quickly there. Not too bad. We have one missile left now, slightly damaged, but nothing too critical for the time being. Reversing up, though, we're taking a look. We're in a fairly good position, actually, where we can prevent the enemy pushing onto the A point. We have a direct view from the route that they will take from their spawn point to that A capture point. Final missile being used. We've got a British torpedo boat, missile away. And really, against small boats, the 25 kilograms of TNT equivalent explosive in those missiles is easily enough to just one-shot kill pretty much any small boat you will see. And of course, since they're guided missiles, ranging, it's not really a problem. Most small boats will be within that 10 kilometer range, so it's generally not going to be a problem. Still, 5 kills relatively quickly there, and then I do get killed by an enemy Jaguar. I find the Jaguar, I personally don't own it, I am currently researching it, and I'm really excited to get that thing because the guns, they just seem so good. And of course, that's at a lower BR than the Saeta, so I can imagine that being quite a lot of fun. So getting into our second game, this time playing a bit more of a passive game at the start, and then later on going to defend the A point. First kill then was on a PT-810, good opportunity to demonstrate the effectiveness of those two 40mm cannons against smaller boats. Second thing we're going to be attempting to kill is an A6M2N, the floatplane version of the early Zero. This presents a good opportunity to demonstrate the surface-to-air capabilities of the Sea Killer missiles. Of course, as I said previously, they do have a proximity fuse, which does make it relatively easy to kill an enemy target. You just really need to get the missile within a rough ballpark, and the proximity fuse will do the rest. Of course, there was the new missile detection system at the time of making this video, so the Zero knows that the missile is coming, and he's trying to dodge it, but thankfully I can get it close enough that it is able to destroy his aircraft, giving me, at this point, a naval kill and an air kill. So I then reverse up. I did slightly run aground, tiny bit of damage to the front of my vessel, probably not the smartest move, but it's not too critical. So going along, we see a PG-02. As stated previously, this thing doesn't necessarily have much armor, so a vessel like the PG-02 that can put out a lot of rounds very quickly is something to be worried about. So I fire a missile. First one actually ghosts. It goes straight through the PG-02. I went in the replay and I noticed it did that. So ghost missiles are a possibility if your connection or the server connection is a bit iffy. Nonetheless, though, second missile goes right in, gets a solid hit into the hull of that PG-02, and of course, he detonates. These missiles, 25 kilograms of explosive mass, as said, that is perfect for taking out smaller vessels. Although, I do then start taking fire from what seems to be a destroyer, and as I said, this thing will not exactly hold up well to main caliber rounds from destroyers or cruisers. Thankfully, though, I was able to get to cover, and the destroyer then subsequently lost interest in attacking me, allowing me to use my final Sea Killer missile to take out an enemy Spaviero who was heading to the A point. Pretty simple there, hit him in the side, and he was just completely destroyed. I then begin to just sort of think through my options. We're at a point where we have less tickets than the enemy, but we do hold majority of the bases, meaning that the enemy are losing their tickets, and I really then sort of decide sticking near the A point is the best course of action. At this point in the game's been going for a good 10-15 minutes. There's not a huge amount of people left on either side, so there's not going to be a huge amount of enemy vessels moving onto that A point. But if I can stay here and defend it, that'll really increase our chances of winning this game. So there's an enemy aircraft coming in. I don't have any Sea Killer missiles left. I do spot an enemy torpedo boat, though, moving out of the spawn, so I fire some shots, spam at him just to keep him away from the A point, and luckily, one of my rounds hits one of these torpedoes, which then subsequently destroys his vessel, giving me another fairly easy kill. Now the plan is really just to reverse back to the A point, reload those Sea Killer missiles, and primarily use them to engage enemy air targets. Of course, quick demonstration of the radar there, I was able to lock a target, find out how far away he was, how quickly he was coming towards me, and of course you want to keep a good eye on the target because it might be that they don't know you're here, they're not going to engage you, and you might be in a position where there's a good chance to engage and kill that target. At this point though, there's a few enemy aircraft up, there's an enemy, I believe it's a K2, coming towards the A point, and he is being engaged by a few other friendly vehicles. I do get a bit worried when I see the P63 diving in when I don't have any sea killers, so I switch over to the proximity fuse rounds, start spamming them. First round doesn't really do anything. He then pulls up out of his attack, and I don't even lock him at this point. I just spam some rounds, and luckily I get a hit. And then in my second burst, after that, I get a critical. Thank God for proximity fuse rounds. He goes down. That's another aircraft kill. There is also an IAR-81. That aircraft has, I forget their name, but they're big German rockets in these sort of tubes under the wings. They will decimate a boat incredibly easily. They are quite powerful rockets. I personally use them in lower tier naval quite a lot. I don't want to get hit by one of them, so I'm keeping an eye on that IAR. But I am close to the A point at this time, so I can reverse up, reload the sea killers, and then we're good to go for destroying more enemy aircraft. There seems to also be a TU-2 coming in. That's quite a dangerous vehicle. And there's the K-2 that I mentioned previously. We're going to fire some shots. He's not too far away, so aiming the 40 mils accurately is not really a problem. He's also going quite slow. I was hoping to kill him, and then I see a few what seem to be 1,000-pound bombs go flying in his direction. And I just decide that it's not going to be my kill, so I go with the assist for that one. But now I'm back in the point. As you can see, we're reloading the sea killers. As soon as I get a missile, I'm scanning around for air targets to attack. I know that the TU-2 is moving in, so I decide, you know, the TU-2 is probably the best target. The IAR is quite low, so I'll probably lose the missile while trying to track him. TU-2, on the other hand, quite a predictable flight course. He's relatively high up, not a huge chance that he's going to escape the missile. And that is, of course, another air kill there quite easily on a fairly large aircraft. So now just scanning around, my launcher is of course still reloading, getting back to 5 missiles, and then I see a friendly aircraft shooting at a boat next to me, and I remember there being a minute ago a friendly boat there. But wait a minute, that's an enemy. So what I'm thinking is this Spaviero probably snuck around the backside of the A point without me noticing as I was focusing on the aircraft, and of course in chat saying thanks to that aircraft for spotting him, because if he didn't, I would have probably been blowing up. So a little reminder there, when you're focusing on aircraft, do also keep a surface scan around, because an enemy boat might sneak up to you. Enemy aircraft, I would have fired a sea killer, but he was in a sort of flight course where he was going to go behind these rocks, and if you don't actually have a line of sight to the missile, you will lose control of the missile, and then that's a missile wasted. So I decided to ignore that Japanese aircraft for the time being and focus on this Stuka. Turns out it was an Italian Stuka. I'm assuming it was the Spaviero that I just killed, but nonetheless, it's an air target. He has a bomb. I don't want to get blown up, so I fire a missile. The game is very nearly ended. Their tickets have ticked down quite quickly. We now have the C point. We have all of the capture points. They're kind of just resorting to attempting to kill us with CAS at this point, but the game, the end of the game being our win, it's sort of inevitable at this point. And then I see gunfire from other friendlies, come to the conclusion that it is that Japanese B7 that we saw previously, load up those proximity fuse rounds, spam them at him as he comes over the hill, and just before the end of the game, I'm able to get my 5th air kill, giving me 5 naval kills, 5 air kills, double ace overall. And that probably is the best game I've had in the Saeta so far. Generally a very nice boat. I really enjoy playing this. I got it, I spaded the thing over the course of a few days, and it was a really fun experience. The only thing that kind of put me off was, again, as I said previously, the kind of empty-looking stock paint scheme. The fact that there is now a user skin on live.warthunder that's a historical skin, but also looks way more interesting, is definitely nice for me. So as I said previously, I hope that user skin ends up on the War Thunder market, although that is probably wishful thinking. But there we go, it has the highest RP cost of any currently available Italian vessel. I can't say it's 100% worth the 270k cost, but it is fun at least. Even without the missiles, it's a blast to play. While lacking survivability against larger vessels, its speed and effective armament makes it a joy to play when facing other small boats. Playing the Saeta and some of the other low-tier Italian vessels, I guess, has actually been a really enjoyable experience for me, which is why I will continue down the Italian line to hopefully get the Trento in good time. I might even make some more videos, firstly looking at the Spaviero and the Fulgore, two other ships that I have enjoyed playing, so do let me know if they are something you would want to see my thoughts on. Anyway though, that's going to be it from me for now. Thank you very much for watching. If you did enjoy, please consider dropping a like on the video, and if you want to see more content like this, subscribe to the channel, and hopefully there'll be some more stuff up relatively soon. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you in the next one.